everyone, and welcome to another episode of Shock and Awe Toy Reviews. Two, sometimes three idiots, one camera, and a review. I am one of your reviewers, Wilson. Next to me is the bearded thunder himself,
Mr. Berg.
And in this episode, we're going to take a brief look at...
This is the, I believe, Amazon-exclusive Star Wars 6-inch Black Series Elite Praetorian Guard with Heavy Blade.
And there you go. Look, you can see that's him in the box, but we don't want to look at the box. Taking a look at him here. As long as you sink your teeth into this guy.
I think he looks awesome. I hope he is awesome. After the Captain Phasma debacle, even though I didn't think she was that cool looking,
The
cool guys will just suck.
I hope there's more than one, or at least there's a cool scene.
Yes.
At the time of this filming, the movie has not come out. It's a week away.
Correct. I really hope they do cool stuff.
Yeah.
Because the Royal Guards, the original trilogy looked awesome, but they just fucking stood there. It wasn't until the comics that they became awesome. These guys have giant weapons. I hope they do.
Yeah.
Rebel, or whatever they're called.
Who cares?
I hope this guy stabs a certain character in the face. That doesn't happen in the movie. There are two characters who, if they both got stabbed in the face...
Okay. One of them, would they have previously been a stormtrooper?
Possibly.
Okay.
And the other one's his best friend.
So we're off to a good start. I don't collect many Star Wars toys. If I do, they're the 6-inch black figures. I bought this guy because visually he's very cool looking.
Yeah.
And I liked the Amazon one because he came with mainly like this huge spear that the other ones didn't seem to come with. He also comes with this antenna sword.
We'll find out what it is.
It looks like a sword. It's probably a sword.
There's actually a lot of paint on this blade. It is cast in red, but there's silver blade, silver handle. There's silver stripes down the bottom. There's some silver detailing up here, which for a Hasbro toy, what? And then he actually does have a little painted thing on his chest, but he's molded in a shiny red plastic. He looks awesome. I actually like they made a lot like a pleather cape instead of, or I don't know, or super, I don't know what it is.
It, you know what it reminds me of? His fruit roll-ups. It's like a thicker fruit roll-up.
I don't know what it is, but it is pliable enough so that he can get into lots of good poses.
And it helps him stand, too.
It looks way better than soft goods. Like a red piece of cape like they would have done in the old days. I'm very happy with him. He's got the standard 6-inch Black Series articulation. His elbows are somewhat limited.
I would say they very much are. As you can see, his whole arm is made up of Dixie cups, basically.
Solo red cups. We bow to no sponsors.
And it makes moving his elbow, I say, quite difficult. It turns this way, but like bending it, you really got to get in there. And if you can see here, actually, doing so at one point sort of bent that piece right there, so you gotta be careful. It's unfortunate. That's one of my big hang-ups with this guy, is his lack of arm articulation because of the design. It's the design's fault, I guess, not the toy, but there's probably a way they could have figured that out
better. I have no problems moving the other one, the regular one.
Oh, you have the regular non-exclusive version?
Yes.
I wonder if it's just to these.
It's the same figure as far as I can.
Really?
I'm sure hopefully someone will point out that I'm totally wrong, but they look, as far as I can remember, same toy.
Oh, maybe I'm doing something wrong then.
Oh, you are Wilson.
Yeah, it would make sense. I'm just, it's hard to see. I mean, again, you can't see where the joint is, so I'm wary to bend it in a certain way because I don't know if I have the arm flipped around and I'd be bending it against the joint.
Sure.
You know, so, yeah, that's a problem, but it's not that big of a deal. I like him enough. He'll fit right next to the three others that I have. I don't know.
He'll look great.
Yeah.
Standing next to Kylo Ren, because I'm not buying Snoke unless he's amazing in the movie. Unless he's a major badass in the movie, I will not be purchasing that toy.
Gotcha.
As for this guy, thumbs up if you can get him.
I give him a thumbs up.
I think he looks awesome. I think he's playable.
You think it's worth it for the Amazon exclusive? I don't think the Amazon one's really any different in price.
I think it's the same price.
Yeah, so I'd say go for this one. From the weapons options I've seen, I like this one better. Yeah, he'll fit right in. He's a thumbs up. Again, if I had actually rated him, I'd probably give him a 2.5. He's fine. I'm not thrilled. The arm thing really just bothers me. I would give him
a 3.5.
Yeah, he just the arm thing looks bizarre to me.
I really, really like the skirt. I dug how they did it.
Yeah. So they have never done anything like that before?
They have. When they do plastic capes, they don't move at all. They're terrible. The one that comes with Kylo Ren is abysmal.
Okay.
Like, it's just like a plastic shell. And when they do soft goods at any scale, especially for Star Wars toys, they're just god-awful.
It has texture and everything. Yeah, it's nice.
Looks like pleather, man. I don't know.
That's been it. Leave comments, like, subscribe, let us know what you think, share with everybody. We appreciate you for watching. We hope you're all doing well, and until next time.
Wipe them out, all of them.